After yesterday's doubleheader sweep of Butler, the Pirates face the Bulldogs again here at Mike Shepard Senior Field. Unfortunately, the Pirates did fall to the Bulldogs in this game in a close 4-3 loss. Myself, Jillian Yarzenbowitz, and Ryan Clayton are here to break down all three games of that series. So, Ryan, let's talk about yesterday's game, the first game in the series. What are your thoughts on it?
So that first game was awesome. Did a great job for the Pirates. It was 12-2. It only ended up going to 5 innings. The bats were hot for the Pirates. In that first inning, they drove in 7 runs, back-to-back homers in that inning by Haley Artuga, who launched a 2-run homer, and then another solo by Bailey Allender. She even launched another home run in the bottom of the third. This was a strong game for the Pirates.
And you can't forget to mention Janae Barricado. She scored 3 of the Halls, 12 runs. Overall, a great game for the Pirates, ending with a 12-2 victory against Butler. Moving on to Game 2, where both teams were trading zeros until the 5th inning with pitchers Regan Camp for the Pirates and Butler's Alyssa Graves. What are your thoughts on that one?
So, yeah, you already mentioned the two pitchers. This was a pitching duel, and the score indicates it. Regan Camp was locked into a pitching duel. Both pitchers shut out the sides for 4 innings. In the 5th inning, the Butler took the lead, but that was quickly broken by Seton Hall. They got right back into this one. In the 7th, the Pirates loaded the bases, but they weren't able to score. But that wouldn't matter because come the 8th inning, it was Allender again with her 3rd home run of the series. As she launched one out, a solo homer to left field for the walk-off win.
And regardless of today's loss, yesterday's wins marked the Pirates' first ever series victory against Butler. Moving on to today's game, the final game in the series. Unfortunately, the Pirates did fall to the Butler Bulldogs with a score of 4-3. All 3 of those runs did occur in that first inning. Ryan, I know you took note of that. What are your thoughts on that?
So yeah, that first inning was really when this thing got off to an offensive battle. In that first inning, the top of the first, Butler was the first to score with an RBI double. And then the Hall quickly responded back, as you mentioned, 3 runs of their own. In the second, though, there was some good pitching on both sides, neither team's really being able to score. But in that third inning is when Butler started to come back, scoring off of a solo homer from Caitlin Dowd to make this score 3-2.
So now at the top of that third inning, the Pirates did switch out pitchers. Regan Camp stepping up and striking out the side in the 4th. And then heading into that 5th inning, she did give up 4 hits, but she struck out 2 to keep that score tied. Now, we did end up going into extra innings in the 6th. Do you care to comment about that?
Yeah, so what actually happened there was Butler would score that tying run to make it 3-3 heading into extras. They scored it off of a wild pitch that was thrown into the dirt. And for the second time in 2 days, Pirates would be heading to extra innings. So in the 7th inning, Pirates did have a chance. They loaded the bases, but were unable to score. And that led us to the 8th, where Butler would score, making the score 4-3. Allender had a great shot to center field that almost went over the wall, but unfortunately would not able to get it over. So the final score being 4-3, Butler would win this one, and Seton Hall would still win the series.
And looking forward to the next game, the Pirates are facing Hofstra this Thursday, April 11th at 4. That about does it here with Pirate TV. Once again, I'm Jill Yarzenbowitz here with Ryan Clayton. Tune in to Hall Talk upcoming.